Do you need to keep track of your worker's time or even your service vendor's time when they work on your jobs? Well, in that case, then you need to learn how to manage time activities in QuickBooks Online. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. If you need to track your workers' or service vendors' time for calculating pay or billing a client, you can use the time activities in QuickBooks Online to record and track these work times. A single time activity is an entry that records the time that a worker or vendor worked for you. A weekly timesheet is simply a set of single time activities grouped by week. These are not transactions. If it is not billable, then they will only appear on one report, a report called Time Activities by Employee Detail. So let's add that to our list of custom reports. In the left panel, we click Reports. Now we have to select the Standard tab because we have to find that report. Scroll down all the way till you get to the section of employees. Again, we will only track the time of independent contractors, even though it's under employees. And this one, Time Activities by Employee Detail. Double click. And now we make the date pull down all dates the way we usually do and click Run Report. Now we click Save Customization and then click Save. Okay, click Replace. Don't worry, I accidentally put it there. Maybe you don't have to click Replace. But if you did it correctly, you can click Reports, Custom Reports, and you can see Time Activities by Employee Detail has been added to your list of custom reports. And if you scroll down further, you can see that at the beginning of the course, we already put up unbilled time in order to track time that was billed and not, marked as billable but not yet billed. So those are the two reports that you will use to manage the time activities. And now that we've added the report to our set of custom reports, we can use these windows for unbilled time. Now, if you're not billing your client for the time, you can still use timesheets or time slips just to keep track of a worker's time. You could also see what jobs the worker spent time on through this report. And recording time slips and timesheets will not affect your financial reports or balances. It's simply a separate set of data for something for you to keep track of. So let's do an individual time activity first. For example, let's imagine on May 1, Bill, the independent builder, worked 4 hours on the Southwoods Road job and it's not billable to Kirschbaum on the Southwoods Road job. So how do we do this for May 1? In the top left, we click New and we go over to where it says Employees, even though Bill is an independent contractor, or vendor in this case, we still have to go to the column of employees and click single time activity. Now let's look at the information. May 1, 4 hours, Southwoods Road job. So we make it May 1, and it's Bill, the independent builder. The job that it was associated, you don't have to associate it with a job, but in this case, he worked on the Southwoods Road job. Now you must remove the billable check mark because we will talk about billable hours in the next video, the video that follows this one. Right now, let's focus on how to record the time. And you have two options. You can click enter start and end time. Look what happens if we enter 1 a.m. and then we enter 3:30 a.m. and then we click here and put break 1, push tab. Notice the summary shows 1 hour and 30 minutes because between this time is 2 hours and 30 minutes, but we put a 1 hour break. Isn't that amazing? You don't have to do it that way. You can remove the check mark and just put 3.5 hours. And it'll show 3 hours and 30 minutes. So those are the two options that you have for recording the amount of time. It's nicer if you do it this way so that the client can see and the worker can see that you log the start and end time and also deducted the break. But we want 4 hours altogether. So we don't want 3:30 a.m. We want maybe 6 a.m. Would that do it? Yep, there you go. 1 a.m. to 6 a.m. with a 1 hour break is a summary of 4 hours. So congratulations, we just recorded our first time activity. Save and close. And when we go back to the report, time activities by employee detail, you can see that it recorded it. You can make a column wider by coming here, and drag it, make it a little wider. But you can see that he worked 4 hours on May 1 on the Southwoods Road job. And you can double click and go back to the actual activity sheet that you recorded the time in the first place. Let's do a second example. Let's imagine on May 2, Lana, the lawyer, worked 3 hours on the Mockingbird Lane job. And again, that's not billable to Mockingbird Lane. So, again, in the top left, we click New. We go over to the column of employees and click Single Time Activity. In this case, it's May 2nd, and the worker is Lana, the lawyer, and we remove this. It's not billable, so remove the check mark. And in this case, she was working on the Mockingbird Lane job. Now again, you can get fancy and put in the start time and end time, but basically she worked 3 hours. So since she works from home, we'll just put 3 because basically all we need to know is how many hours she worked. And this is what this single time activity slip or sheet would look like. Save and close. And now when we go back to the time activities by employee detail, you can see that Lana worked on the Mockingbird, you have to make this a little longer, Mockingbird Lane job on May 2nd for 3 hours. And if we double click to come back to this time slip, all we get is the time, not the start and end time with break, because that's the way that we recorded this in the time activity window. A weekly timesheet is simply a set of single time activities grouped by week. You can enter time in the weekly timesheets or individually, and they will be listed the same way in the report. If you reopen the time activity from the report, you will only see the individual time activity one by one, and you will not see the entire weekly timesheet. The only way to see the whole weekly timesheet you recorded is to go back to the window that you entered the weekly timesheet in and choose the specific week and the specific worker for that timesheet. And there's usually no need for that. Usually the report is enough. For example, let's imagine on May 10, Bill, the independent builder, worked 2 hours on the South Woods Road job, and it's not billable. And let's imagine May 11th, Bill, the independent builder, worked 3 hours on the Mockingbird Lane job. And again, it's not billable. So we can make a weekly timesheet just for Bill, and we will see how it looks. So, in order to record this, sorry, I was playing with that. In order to record this, in the top left, we click New, go over to Weekly Timesheet. Now, we have to choose the correct worker or vendor, and if we're doing a whole week's timesheet, we have to choose a block of time for a week, and QuickBooks will identify this sheet as the worker and the week. Now that we have the correct dates, let's fill in the details. So May 10th, 2 hours on the South Woods Road job. Now each row is meant for a separate job or client. So we choose the job that he worked on in the same row as the day that he worked. And this is showing that on Sunday, May 10th, he worked 2 hours on the South Woods Road job, and it's not billable. However, on Monday, May 11th, he worked 3 hours on the Mockingbird Lane job. So if it's a different job, you would go to the next row, choose the job, then go across the row to the day that the worker worked, and type in the number of hours. Of course, in both cases, you have an opportunity to put in a description of what the worker did. Now, when we click Save and Close, we can take a look at the time activities by employee detail, and you can see the individual time slips are listed one by one on the report, not the sheet itself. If you double-click on any of these, you will not go back to the weekly timesheet. It will only open the actual activity in this format, even though you recorded this in the timesheet, weekly timesheet window. If you need to see the actual sheet itself, which is very rare, you would have to reopen the very same window that you opened in the first place to record it, and you would have to choose the worker and choose that same block of time that you originally recorded it in, and then the information that you recorded would come up.